Well, hi there. I'm Jennifer Latsky, and I'm an associate editor with High Plains Journal in Dodge City, Kansas. And we're here today with Indigo CEO David Perry. We're going to chat with him at our Wheat Solutions event here in Wichita. David, how did Indigo come to be? Where did this idea come from? You've got an entrepreneurial spirit. You've started several companies. Where did this call come out from?
Well, it's a complex story, honestly. I grew up on a farm. I'm from Arkansas originally, and so started my life that way, and then went on to do other stuff. So I really spent the last 20 years of my career starting and running software companies and human health biotechnology companies. And when I had the opportunity in 2014 to step back and say, what do I want to do next? Mm-hmm. What I realized is that some of the biggest problems facing us as a planet and us as a society are the problems of food and agriculture. You know, namely, how are we going to feed everyone? Mm-hmm. How can we do it in a more environmentally sustainable way? How can we do it in a way that's healthier for consumers? And key to all of that is how can we do it in a way that's profitable for farmers? And so I was looking for technologies to apply to that, or business to start or buy, and found 13 scientists in a lab in Cambridge, Massachusetts, mm-hmm. working on microbiology, using microbes to improve plant health and protect plants from stresses, and decided that it was the most interesting combination of technology and unmet need I'd seen, and moved to Boston to start Indigo.
Well, and it's really taking it to the plant level. You know, mm-hmm. we're so used to, as farmers and ranchers, applying something on top of the ground, yeah. on top of the plants. And yep. this is really ground level, looking at what actually makes that plant so healthy. That's quite fascinating, actually.
Yeah, well, you know, one of the interesting things about microbes is, for most of human history, we've thought of them as the enemy. Mm-hmm. You know, how do we get rid of microbes that cause disease? But we now know, just in the last 10 years or so, that microbes actually improve health of living things, including mm-hmm. humans and agricultural crops. And by putting microbes on the seed, they then get taken up by the plants when that seed germinates, mm-hmm. multiply inside of the plant, and can protect that plant throughout its life cycle.
Fascinating, absolutely fascinating. So overall, when you look at the goals of Indigo, you have the goals for the farmer and the producers, mm-hmm. and the goals for the consumers, ultimately, of our crops and our products.
Yeah.
How do you marry those two together? How do you make them match?
This match should be easy. Mm-hmm. And for all of human history, it's been easy, but for the last 50 years or so. Mm-hmm. You know, originally, farmers grew food for themselves and their close families, and then, you know, gradually, as societies and civilizations expanded, mm-hmm. there became a disconnect between the farmer that was growing the food and the consumer. And over the last 50 years, that disconnect has become greater than it's ever been before in human history. Mm-hmm. But consumers are looking to reclaim that connection. You know, more than any time recently, consumers care about where their food comes from and how it's produced. And so we think we have the opportunity to give them that through transparency all the way from the farm to the consumer, so they know where that food comes from and how it was grown. And that's beneficial to the farmer too, mm-hmm. because now, for the farmer, instead of just producing a commodity crop, mm-hmm. they're actually producing a specialty, a value-added crop that meets the needs of that consumer, whatever they may be, whether that's lower carbon emissions, mm-hmm. or less water use, or whatever it is that's important to them.
You can track that from the
yeah.
field to the bin yeah. to the ultimate consumer.
Growers and consumers are fundamentally aligned. Everybody wants the same thing. Mm-hmm. Indigo's job is just connect those two things.
Well, I've heard this phrase tossed around a lot. It's a paradigm shift.
Yeah.
So what excites you about this? Having a farm background, working and talking with the farmers today,
yeah.
and talking with consumers, what excites you and makes you happy to wake up in the morning?
Well, I think it's the impact that we can have on agriculture. Mm-hmm. You know, agriculture is a little stuck. Mm-hmm. You know, the innovation has really plateaued across the existing technologies, and that disconnect between consumers and farmers is working against both. Mm-hmm. If we can connect those together, it's better for everybody. You know, we have a
a fundamental benefit to farmers because we can improve their profitability, and a fundamental benefit to consumers because we'll be able to provide them what they want.
Wonderful. Well, thank you so much. This has been Jennifer Latsky with High Plains Journal. And for more information about this event and other events, please visit us online at www.hpj.com. Thanks again.
Thank you.